Good morning, good stupid o'clock morning to everyone. Welcome to another episode of Spilling Tea. I am your host, Tiffany Daniels. So we had some good news yesterday, but we are going to get back to doing what we were before, which is going through, taking a look at how other media outlets have been reporting and how frequently they have chosen to update this story in regards to the FDA's ban being overturned. And this is a publication I am actually very familiar with. It's called the DisabilityScoop.com. I've been familiar with it ever since I was with the state as the advocacy specialist for the Department of Mental Health. It's a go-to for some people on disabilities, but one of the largest percentages of people who go to these publications are parents, which I find that extremely important because we want to reach parents that are considering sending these kids to this school. So I wanted to take a look at their perspective. This is the first time I am reading this. This was done back on July 12th, so a few days after the overturn went viral. So, before we go ahead and get started, as usual, the disclaimers. Okay, first of all, you will find the link to the article right there in the description, as other pertinent links to the Stop the Shocks campaign. Most importantly, right now, the templates in order to reach out to your state senators. Why is that so important? Because as of right now, a bill is getting ready to move on to the Senate to be voted on to remove public funding from any special education school that is used shocks for punishment. This will cut off funding from the JRC, basically cutting them off at the knees, not only with a possibility of stopping the shocks, but possibly even going that one step further and closing them down. Which, let's face it, with how often these folks seem to get their judgments overturned, they need to be shut down. It's really the only way. They've proven that in the past. So, please use those templates, send them off to their senators. We really need you guys right now. And don't forget to keep your eyes on Massachusetts, where their state legislator is getting ready to vote on the H225. All right, also, disclaimer, when we are talking about the JRC, you will hear vivid descriptions of, and sometimes see actual video surveillance footage of people with disabilities being tortured and abused. If you have young children present, please, folks, go ahead and use your headphones. Also, it is, let's see here, 4:34 a.m., stupid o'clock in the morning. It is before the butt crack of dawn, folks, so if you could, please forgive me if I stumble over any of my words in advance. Please and thank you. All right, so without further ado, let's take a look at the Disability Scoop coverage of the overturn. It says, Court throws out FDA ban on shock devices for those with developmental disabilities by Sean Heasley. A federal appeals court has overturned a Food and Drug Administration ban on devices used to administer electric shocks on people with disabilities, allowing the devices to continue to be used to address behavior issues. Oh my God, every single publication, God damn it all, to address behavior issues. So, we're going to use a of punishment we don't even allow on dogs or cats anymore to address behavior issues on human beings. They're not using them to address behavior issues, folks. It's bullshit. And it's victim blaming. And I am goddamn tired. I am sick, I'm tired, I'm fucking exhausted of seeing this bullshit be hashed out in media outlet after media outlet. They can tell you all they want it is to address behavior issues, but there are thousands of ways other than this to address behavior issues. And I'm sorry, folks. It is literally addressing anything that has to do with non-compliance. Let's call it what the fuck it is. It is used for any type of dissent, anything that is not considered normal behavior or obeying the person in authority. Okay? Sorry. I have less of a filter in the mornings, can you tell? In a 2-1 opinion this month, the U.S. Court of Appeals for the D.C. Circuit found that the FDA overstepped its authority when it issued a regulation last year to bar what are known as electrical stimulation devices. I know I talk about this all the time, but how the fuck did they overstep their authority? It is their job to regulate devices, food, and prescription medication. That is literally their job description. That is the statute under which they operate. So how is doing their job overstepping all of a sudden? God. If they're overstepping, then fine. Make the CDC regulate it and just get rid of the FDA. Because if y'all are not going to let them do their damn jobs, what's the point of them existing? But anyways, the devices send electrical shocks through electrodes attached to the skin in order to condition people not to engage in self-injurious or aggressive behaviors. Oh my God. I really used to have respect for Disability Scoop, but what the hell am I even reading right now? What the hell is this? Condition? Why don't you just use brainwash? Why don't you just use brainwash? Because that's what this sounds like. We're going to use torture to brainwash people in order to get a wanted behavior as opposed to an unwanted behavior. Conditioning, brainwashing, behavioral modification, control. Are you hearing these words? Are you hearing these words and how dangerous they are? If we were to use those terms towards any other minority group, other than people with disabilities, people would be out in the streets with torches and pitchforks. I'm just saying. No, you know what? I'm going to say it again. If words like conditioning, behavior modification, control, teaching compliance was used in regards to when speaking about any other minority, you all would be out with your pitchforks and your torches. But it's perfectly fine when using these words, these dangerous words, when it comes to people with disabilities. Why? Why? Think about that. I want you to really think about that. Not to mention the fact They mention self-interest or aggressive behaviors. Guess what, folks? That's not all they're getting shocked for. And I'm sick and tired of these publications just automatically assuming that this center is telling the truth when we have literal video evidence that shows exactly the opposite. But in the days with people like AH, I guess we can't, evidence just doesn't matter anymore. Now does it? Moving on. The devices are only known to be used in one place, the Judge Rotenberg Educational Center in Canton, Mass., which serves children and adults with developmental disabilities, as well as those with behavioral and emotional problems. The facility has faced criticism for years from the disability advocates who argue that skin shocks amount to torture. Okay, and having worked for the Department of Mental Health, I'm sorry, but I gotta stop this again. One of the worst things you can do in healthcare, regardless of the disability, is what I like to call the cookie cutter approach. What do I mean by cookie cutter approach? Cookie cutter approach is when you put everyone under the same treatment program, regardless of what their disability happens to be, what their particular issues are, and whether they differ from everybody else you've put under this treatment. Why the hell would you put people with developmental disabilities under the same treatment as somebody with a mental illness, as the same as somebody with emotional issues? It goes on. There are separate treatments that are designed specifically for a particular disability or a mental health issue. It is beyond dangerous, psychologically as well as otherwise, to treat all disabilities and mental health issues the same. What in the name of God are these people thinking? But moving on. The facility has faced criticism for years from the disability advocates who argue that skin shocks amount to torture. Again, here we go. It's just us disability advocates. It's not. When you have the UN stepping in demanding investigations, it's not just disability advocates anymore. Oh, but we don't like to report on that. But backers of the center insist that the electric shocks offer a necessary option for people with severe behaviors who've exhausted other treatments. But have they? We're just supposed to take their word for that. And I'm sorry, that's just not good enough. What other treatments have you tried? What were the results? Did any of these treatments ever seek to find out what exactly is setting off these behaviors? I call bullshit. You can tell me you've exhausted all other treatments, but until you tell me what those treatments are, and if any of those treatments, any of them at all, did anything to try to find the underlying issue that is causing the issues to pop up, the behaviors, then you haven't tried everything. Anyway, when the FDA finalized the regulation, it cited an unreasonable and substantial risk of illness or injury from the device. It's pointed to the evidence of psychological and physical risks, including burns, tissue damage, worsening underlying systems, depression, anxiety, and post-traumatic stress disorder. Yeah, they're being tortured like the freaking war criminals from back in the day. Jesus Christ, are they kidding me? The Federal Appeals Court determined that while the FDA has the authority to ban a device, the agency acted inappropriately because the regulation only sought to disallow electrical stimulation devices for the purpose of treating aggressive or self-injurious behavior while continuing to allow the devices for other uses. Okay, here's what I don't understand. The FDA was targeting a particular device. They were not targeting all freaking devices that use electric shock everywhere, but a particular device made at a particular school that is the only place that uses it. So how is them banning it? God, I don't even know. The stupid of this decision is mind-blowing. The court found that such a limited ban amounted to the regulating the practice of medicine, which is outside the purview of the FDA. Well, then they might as well have no authority over a prescription, should they? God. Currently, the Rotenberg Center said it uses the device called the Graduated Electronic Decalator of, or GED, with 51 residents, all of whom are adults. The court decision means that the practice can continue. Yeah, I'm not going to even read that stupid sentence because I'm tired of seeing it, and quite frankly, it makes me want to vomit. I don't want to read the parents praising the torture of their kids either. If I want to see freaking brainwashed minions, I'll go ahead and watch another special on freaking Doomstown. Oh, thank God. Finally, somebody who got a quote from us. Okay. Advocates with the Autistic Self-Advocacy Network, which has long pushed to end use of the skin shock devices, said the FDA needs to take a firmer stand. The next step is clear, the group said in a statement. The FDA must completely ban the GED and similar devices. ASAN calls on the FDA to immediately pursue a new complete ban. We will continue to advocate fiercely until this torture is finally ended. The FDA said it does not comment on possible pending or ongoing litigation. By the way, it's not just ASAN, folks. It's also ADAPT. It's also the ARC of the United States. It's also the International Disability Rights Organizations. It's also the UN Special Rapporteur on Torture. The list goes on how many big names are fighting against this, which you saw yesterday from the news. So, what do we think of this article? It seems very much to the majority of the article that Disability Scoop is on the side of the center, right up until the very end. The very end, they have literally been the only publication to actually reach out to us or even quote us in this story. So it makes me think over what I just read. The majority of the people who read Disability Scoop, let's face it, are parents and parent advocates. So they want to seem balanced and fair. They don't want to simply dismiss the idea that there are some behavior issues, some that are severe, some that can seriously cause harm to themselves or their children. Fair. Fair. And many families are desperate. They don't have access to information quite as freely as we do. especially in minority communities and in rural communities and the poor communities. They want to address that these issues exist. Sure, fair. But as much as this is relatively balanced, we can't simply trust the Judge Rotenberg Center when they say it is for the worst of the worst, and that they only use it very rarely, when we have mountains and mountains and mountains, years, going all the way back to 1976 evidence that shows the complete opposite. Not only is it not the last resort, it is literally the first resort. They go immediately to food deprivation, sleep deprivation. They go immediately to the shocks. For the love of God, why is it that the first thing you're going to do when somebody refuses to remove their coat is to shock them? Really? Really? Just saying. Okay, overall, not a bad article, but here's my advice for some of these parent groups. Whereas I do think it is important to talk about these issues, because I do know some of us, not all of us, and many parents use it as a way to hammer us down. But that doesn't mean I'm not going to address the fact that some of us have harmed our parents and harmed our siblings in meltdown. Okay? Or have caused major property damage. Okay? I have. It was more property damage than damage to any human being, but obviously, you see my point. I do recognize that. However, this is not the way to address it. And the way it is worded here is, well, let's just say you saw what it did with me. We can address that these issues exist. And we can word it in such a way that it doesn't seem like it is victim blaming. All right, folks, that's all I got for this morning. Now, before we head out, we don't get very many views on this channel, as you all know. The few that we do tend to get removed from time to time. So, folks, if you would be so kind, please don't forget to hit that like button, hit subscribe. Don't forget to hit the comments. I do appreciate your time, and as always, we here at Spilling Tea hope you have a good one. Bye-bye.